So in today's video, we are going to learn how to solve circuit problems using Norton's theorem. We are going to learn how to find the Norton's current, the Norton's resistance, and the current flowing through a particular resistor. Now, if today is your first time seeing this channel, do well to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and share the video to all your friends. So without wasting much time, let's get into today's lesson. So Norton's theorem states that any linear network or any linear circuit connected between two terminals can be replaced by a Norton's current, and that is IN, in parallel with a Norton's resistance, RN, connected between the same two terminals. So IN, which is the Norton's current, is the current that flows in the short circuit between the two terminals, and RN, which is the Norton's resistance, is equal to the equivalent resistance seen between the two terminals when all the independent sources are deactivated. So the circuit we have here is called the Norton's equivalent circuit. So assuming you want to find the current flowing through a particular resistor, then we are going to connect the resistor between the two terminals, and that is called the load resistor. Now to find the current flowing through this load resistor, that is given by current flowing through the load resistor is equal to the value of the other resistor, which is the Norton's resistance, RN, divided by the sum of the two resistors. So we have RN plus RL times the value of the total current, which is the Norton's current approaching this junction. So basically, this is how to find the current flowing through the load resistor using Norton's theorem. Now let's focus on how to arrive at the Norton's equivalent circuit. So given any linear network, these are the various steps we are going to consider in order to produce the Norton's equivalent circuit, and then move on to find the current flowing through the load resistor. So the first thing we are going to do is to remove the resistor we want to find the current flowing through, and then we mark out the terminals. Secondly, we want to find the short circuit current through the two terminals, that is IN, the Norton's current, using Kirchhoff's voltage law. Thirdly, we are going to deactivate all the independent sources and find the value of RN. Now, in deactivating the independent sources, we are going to short circuit all voltage sources and then open circuit all current sources. Next, we are going to produce the Norton's equivalent circuit reconnecting the load resistor. So that is where we are going to reconnect this load resistor in between the two terminals, and then we can move on to find the current through the load resistor using the current division rule. Now what you need to understand is that the approach to Norton's theorem is similar to that of Thevenin's theorem, and the two are kind of related. So the Norton's resistance is equal to the Thevenin's resistance, and the Norton's current is equal to the Thevenin's voltage divided by the Thevenin's resistance. So basically, these are the relationships between the two theorems. Now let's move on as we solve a couple of examples. So let's take example one. Find the current in the 3 ohms resistor of the circuit below. So we are going to find the current in this 3 ohms resistor using Norton's theorem. Now the first thing we need to do is to remove the resistor we want to find the current flowing through. So we are going to remove this 3 ohms resistor and then mark out the terminals and then replace this resistor with a short circuit current and find the value of the short circuit current. So let's redraw this circuit. So we have this to be the 2 ohm resistor, 1 ohm resistor, and we have the two terminals AB, and then we are going to replace the resistor with a short circuit current, that is IN, the Norton's current. Now let's distribute current in this circuit. Now we have three voltage sources, 5 volts, 4 volts, and then 6 volts. In order to distribute current in this circuit, we are going to consider the conventional flow of current. That is to say that we are going to consider current to move from the positive terminal of the voltage sources. So let's consider the 6 volts. Now this voltage source is going to drive current, say I, through the 2 ohms resistor from the positive terminal in the anticlockwise direction approaching this junction. Similarly, we have this 4 volts also driving current, say I1, through the 1 ohm resistor also approaching this junction. So at this junction, we have two current values, I and then I1, meeting and then moving in the anticlockwise direction. So the total current moving in this direction is I plus I1. Now considering the 5 volts, you realize that this voltage source has been inverted. And since we still want to consider the conventional flow of current, this time we are going to assume current to leave the negative terminal of this voltage source. However, because it's going to leave the negative terminal, we are going to negate the value of the current, so that we have negative I2 flowing through the 1 ohm resistor. So the value of this current, that is negative I2, is going to combine with I plus I1 and then flow through the short circuit. Now the main reason why all the current produced by the voltage sources are going to flow through the short circuit is that the current produced by each of the voltage sources would like to flow in the least resistant part. That is to say, would like to flow through the short circuit and then return to the voltage sources. That is why we have all the current values combining and then flowing through the short circuit. So from this, we can develop an equation for IN. So we say that IN is equal to I plus I1 minus I2. So I plus I1 minus I2. Now let's call this equation 1. In the next step, we are going to find the values of I, I1 and then I2 so that we can find the value of IN. So to find the value of I, we are going to use Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now let's consider this loop. Going through this loop, you realize that we have only one current value, that is the current produced by the 6 volts. So this current value, I, is going to flow through the 2 ohms resistor and then through the short circuit and then return to the negative terminal of the voltage source. Therefore, if you want to find the value of I, we say that the applied voltage, which is 6 volts, is equal to the sum of the voltage drops across the circuit. So that is 2 times I. We divide through by 2, and then we have the value of I to be 3 amperes. Now let's do same for I1. So to find the value of I1, we are going to take this path, and then you realize that the only current value we have is the current value produced by the 4 volts. So similarly, we have 4 equals I1 times 1, which is still I1. Therefore, we say that I1 is equal to 4 amperes. Now for I2, we have I2 also moving in the clockwise direction through this loop and then returning to the voltage source. Therefore, if you want to find the value of I2, then we are going to negate the value of the voltage source because you have the current flowing from the negative terminal. So that becomes negative 5 equals negative I2 times R, which is 1 ohm. So this becomes negative I2, and then we can divide through by negative 1 so that we have I2 equals 5. Now negative 5 equals negative I2 times 1 makes a lot of sense, because for KVL, the applied voltage should be equal to the sum of the voltages dropped across the circuit. Now since we have the values of I2, I1 and then I, we can find the value of In. Therefore we have In to be equal to 3 plus 4 minus 5. 3 plus 4 is 7, minus 5 is 2. Therefore we have the Norton's current to be 2 amperes. Now let's move on and find the Norton's resistance. So still focusing on this circuit, we are going to deactivate the voltage sources by short circuiting them. So we have this 1 ohm. We have this to be the opening for Rn between the two terminals. So let's find the value of Rn. Clearly, you realize that you can go through this loop without passing through any other circuit element except the two resistors. So they are in parallel. And then their combination will also be in parallel with this 2 ohms resistor. Therefore, we say that Rn is equal to 1 parallel 1 or parallel 2. So 1 parallel 1 is the same as 1 times 1 divided by 1 plus 1, and that is equal to 1 over 2. So that is 0.5. So we have 0.5 parallel 2. So that is 0.5 times 2 divided by 0.5 plus 2. 0.5 times 2 is 1. 0.5 plus 2 is 2.5. And then 1 divided by 2.5 is 0.4. So we have Rn to be 0.4 ohms. Now let's find the current flowing through the 3 ohms resistor. So to do so, we need to redraw the Norton's equivalent circuit. So for the Norton's equivalent circuit, we have the Norton's current in parallel with the Norton's resistance, that is Rn, and then we have the load resistor connected between the two terminals, that is RL, which is 3 ohms. Now take notice of the direction of the Norton's current. It is directed downwards. So we have In to be 2 amperes, Rn to be 0.4, and then we want to find the value of the current flowing through RL. So this will be the direction of In, and then the current flowing through RL is going to move in this direction. So to find the current flowing through RL, that is equal to the current flowing through the 3 ohms resistor. So we have Rn, which is 0.4 divided by 0.4 plus 3 times the value of the Norton's current. Therefore we have the current flowing through the 3 ohms resistor to be 0.235 amperes.